Hello, my dear lovely friends. Namaste to all of you. Hope you've been doing absolutely great. This is Ambika and welcome back to my channel. Well, in today's video, we are going to talk about something that most students ask me. Well, for starters, I must tell you that right now, I think most of my subscribers, most of my regular viewers out there include a good majority of students, obviously because I've been in the teaching field for quite some time and online teaching, and many of you know that. So probably that's why many of you keep commenting with requests regarding, ma'am, can you talk about this in your next video? Can you talk about this particular subject for this particular grade? Can you talk about a few study hacks? So yes, talking about study hacks, that's exactly what we are going to be talking about today. I must tell you something. When I say study hacks, it just takes me back to my student days, my school days, my college days. Until the very last day of my college, I think studying has always been something that I really, really enjoyed. Regardless of whether I scored very good marks or became a topper, I'm not talking about any of that at all, or whether I was not scoring well for some exams, I'm not talking about the results at all, but just the act of studying, I must admit, has always been something that I was always fascinated about. I always loved exploring more techniques. And I think that's probably coming in handy right now, because now that I interact with a lot of students, I think my experience of exploring study techniques back in my generation, which was like 10, 20 years ago when I did my school, college and all of that, I think many of those, most of those would still work regardless of all the scientific and digital advancements that we have. So of course, the list can be endless. The number of study hacks that we could list out can be just endless, because everyone who has explored this will have their own set of hacks to share with you. So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you three study hacks, which I would say three of my favorite study hacks, three among my favorite study hacks rather. Okay, so now who would this benefit? Would it be only school children? No, I must say anyone who studies, school, college, well, high school, higher secondary, college, engineering, medicine, or a regular science degree or an arts degree, a commerce student, a CA student, anyone at all, because this is not subject specific. Okay, so it's going to be three general tips which have worked for me as a student, and as a result I have always been sharing these with my students, so they have also benefited from this, because I keep receiving feedback from them as well. Okay, so the first one, study hack number one that I want to share with you today is know your strengths and weaknesses. Now this is super important, because without knowing what I am good at and what I'm weak at, I can't plan anything for myself, right? Because when, say for example, when my friend probably is very good in physics and I'm not so good at physics, my friend might need just 30 minutes to read through and study one particular topic thoroughly well. But on the contrary, because I'm not so great in physics, I may need 2 hours, 3 hours, or sometimes if I'm really weak at it, perhaps one entire day. So that's because I'm weak at it. But is that a problem? No, it's not. So what is the problem? Is it that you are weak in a particular subject? No, that is not the problem. Definitely not. Because we are all individual. We are all unique and different in our own ways, right? So the problem comes when you don't know what your weakness is, when you don't know what your strengths are. I'm sure if you just took out 15-20 minutes sometime during the day when you are all by yourself, and maybe like take out a notepad and pencil or pen or something, and write down what you like doing and what you don't like doing, what easily comes to you, what doesn't easily come to you, but be very, very honest with yourself in this exercise, you will have all your answers, definitely. But this is a very, very important step to take, because without knowing what you're good at and what you're not so good at can do a lot of amazing things when it comes to your study time, especially. Well, not just in study time, I must say, when you know, as long as you know your strengths and weaknesses in anything at all, as a person, as a human being, I think it really helps you evolve into a better individual as well. So in the long run, definitely that is what matters. But now, talking about study hacks, definitely as the top study hack, I would list this, okay? So identify your strengths and weaknesses. So is it just about the subject that I'm talking about? No, it's not just about the subject. The subject is definitely one thing, because some of you are good at science, some of you are not so good at science, some of you are good at math and some of you are not, some of you are very good in English, some of you may not, and your respective state languages, if at all you have different other languages, second languages, third languages, and all of those that you have to learn, anything at all. Some of them, some children naturally have a flair for it, some children don't. So yes, identify that, what you're good at, what you're not good at, okay? The idea is, once you have identified your strengths and weaknesses, it's not a good idea to stress over it. Rather, you must feel very, very happy with yourself, because congratulations, you would have done an amazing job of saving your time in the long run, okay? So that is the very first tip, subject, strength and weakness. And the second sub tip under my first study hack, we're still talking about strengths and weaknesses. The second one is time of studies during the day, okay? So of course, we all know we all have the same 24 hours in a day. But why is it that some of us don't find the time for certain things, while some others really seem to be having the time for everything in the world, right? I think that's different for different people, but the idea lies in knowing your strengths and weaknesses with regard to what time of the day your brain works sharpest. For example, why am I talking about this? Many children ask me, is it the best idea to study early in the morning? Or is it a good idea? Is it an equally good idea to study late in the night as well? Because I'm a late night person. I'm not talking about myself. Some of my children tell me I'm a late night person. So I prefer studying when everyone at home is asleep. The neighborhood is very, very quiet. So I like starting around 9, 10 p.m. and I like to study till 1 or 2 a.m. So that works for me perfectly well. So I would say, don't disturb that routine, because you have identified that your brain works sharpest at that time. But then, the next day, if you sleep at 1 a.m. or 2 a.m., are you going to be able to get enough sleep before you attend school for the next day or your online classes for the next day? Yes, you need to have at least about 7 to 8 hours of sleep, especially in your growing years. I have always emphasized on this in all my classes, and I still say this, 7 to 8 hours of sleep and nothing less, okay? So make sure you feel rested when you wake up. As long as you have that balance, studying late into the night is never a problem, according to me, okay? Because that works best for some people, whereas for some other people, for some other children, they may prefer to wake up at 5 a.m., 4 a.m., whatever suits them, and they feel that their mind is very fresh and they feel well rested after a good night's sleep. So they feel like they're on top of the world. So anything, any complex concepts, they feel that they can absorb and grasp very easily when they wake up early in the morning. So just because your best friend is an early morning person doesn't mean you have to be an early morning person as well, okay? No competition in this at all. You decide what works best for you. That's all that matters. So these are the two major things coming under strengths and weaknesses. First of all, identify your strong and weak subjects. And secondly, identify what time of the day suits you best to study, okay? Alright, so that is study hack number one, identifying strengths and weaknesses. Study hack number two, have a very, very, very clear plan for the entire day, for each day, okay? So I would say ideally you must have a plan at least for a week ahead. On Sunday, I'm going to be doing this, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, because every day you would be involved in other activities as well. It's not just self-studies that you do. Obviously, your school lessons, your school homework, your school tests, your other assignments, maybe any other private tuitions that you may be attending, maybe any other hobby classes that you may be attending. You need time for everything. Come on, you don't have to give up all that fun just because you are a student or preparing for a very, very important exam. There has to be a balance. As long as that balance is there, that's it. You don't have to worry at all. Okay? So make time for everything. Have a very, very clear plan. So when I say very clear plan, you need to know how many hours in a day you want to allot to studies. I would suggest, if you are a high school student, I would suggest at least 2 to 3 hours of self-study in a day would be very, very good. If you can manage more, absolutely great. And if you cannot manage even that much, maybe you can start with 1 hour a day and gradually increase it to 1 hour 15 minutes, 1 hour 30 minutes, and try coming up to 2 to 3 hours in a day. Okay? So just because I said the number of hours, don't get stressed over that idea at all. I'm just giving you a rough estimate just in case you are an absolute beginner in learning to plan for yourself. Okay? So that is about planning for the day. So I want to study for 3 hours a day. I have 5 hours of online classes at school during the day. So I need time for that as well. I need 2 hours for school assignments. I need 1 hour for my hobby classes. And of course, that's not it. Your personal routine, family time, maybe play time, finding time for things that you really, really love doing, any other art and craft or music or anything at all. You need to have time. Food, you have to eat well, you have to exercise well. Everything goes together as a package. Feels like a lot when I say it, I know, I understand that. But trust me, it's very, very simple. As long as you have allotted sections during the day for all of these tasks. Okay, so make a plan for at least a week. If possible, okay, if possible, it would be awesome if you could make a clear timetable. 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. for studies, 7 to 8 breakfast time, maybe take a shower, and then 8:30 to 12:30 school online classes. If you can plan it hour by hour like that, it would be great. But if not, go at least one step at a time. Dedicate at least the number of hours first, and what time of the day you wish to fit that into, maybe you can come to it a little later when you are really confident about trying this routine. Okay? Right, so that's about making a clear plan for the entire day. Right, so talking about the entire day, one additional tip I need to give you here. Many times when I was a student, of course, my school wasn't very close to home. It was about, I think, 6-7 kilometers away from home. And traffic in my city used to be quite bad. So travel time, yes, it was a little annoying, especially when I was in 10th and 12th and there was a lot to study and all of those. But then a tip that I realized later, I think maybe towards the end of my university days, was that you can always use small pockets of time. You know what I mean by that? There may be a bit of time, a bit of extra time, 5 minutes or 10 minutes that you spend in the bus or of course now because of COVID things may be different. You may not be traveling much, but generally this does happen to many children. Okay, even if it's not traveling, there may be times during the day when you feel you're not really utilizing properly. I just hope you get a chance to notice those tiny pockets of time, 5 minutes or 10 minutes, sometime during the day, and maybe just read through little notes that you have, maybe a formula book or a book of definitions or anything at all, or just one simple concept, maybe photosynthesis, maybe respiration, human physiology, one small topic, something at all. If you can manage to use 5 or 10 minutes during the day, and if you can manage to use many different pockets of time during the day like that, you will be really, really surprised to see how much time it can save you. And I remember when I interacted with one of the toppers last year at Vedantu. I think her name was Meera, if I remember right. You can see that video as well. It will be on the Vedantu channel. But anyway, when I spoke to her, because Toppers Talk, we had a series like that on the Vedantu channels. And that child told me something similar to this. She said, while she was in school, she would complete all the school homework in the school itself. Maybe like 2 minutes gap before the next teacher comes into class, she would try and finish at least a bit of homework that before carrying it home in the evening. Or maybe during the lunch break, take 5 extra minutes off your break. Of course, this may not suit everyone, but this is what that child told me. And I think that is superb. So you don't have to think too much about it. Try to finish as much as you can in the first half of the day. So maybe in the second half of the day, you have a lot of time to do your self-studies. It can save you a lot of time in the long run for sure. A lot of 5 minutes, 10 minutes, of course, would add up to a lot, right? Tiny drops make a mighty ocean. We all know this, okay? So that is study hack number two. Have a clear plan for the day. Of course, using small pockets of time is your own smartness that may not necessarily fit into your timetable, okay? So you must know how to use that. Now, the third and the last one, this is my favorite. Teach someone, or teach yourself rather. Just teach when I say, okay? Because even when I was a school student, I used to love teaching a particular concept, either by looking into the mirror, looking at myself, or sometimes when we would do group studies, of course, with dependent or reliable friends, rather, reliable group, study group, we would love teaching each other. And the topics which I did like that, which I studied like that, are still fresh in my memory. Okay, so that has an amazing magical power, because even scientifically it's been proven that studying through teaching has an amazing impact on your brain. It's I think about 70-80% more effective than sitting at the desk and just reading through a concept. It's got amazing results. Okay, I must tell you this. So you may not be the kind of person who wishes to study in a group. I have always had times in life where most of the time I would prefer to study on my own. Sometimes group study, but of course, as I said, only if there were reliable friends around. But otherwise, group study, no, definitely not. Individual studies have always been the best. So at those points of time, I had this small whiteboard in my room. I still remember that. And I had a whiteboard marker. I would pretend that there was a group of students in front of me, and I would pretend that I'm a teacher. I'm about to teach them. I study a particular concept, I just recall it to myself a couple of times, write it on the board, and just present it to my imaginary class, to my imaginary audience. That's got an amazing impact. It gives you amazing results, okay? And this is one idea. Or if you have a parent or a sibling or a good friend or a cousin or anyone who would have the patience to just sit with you and listen to you, if you want to teach them, great, so do that, nothing better than that. Or if you just prefer to sit down at your desk with a notebook and pen and pretend that there is someone next to you, maybe you can keep a stuffed toy if you really want the presence of someone else there, you can have it as well. And just teach on your notebook. You don't need to have any fancy equipment for this. Just because I said whiteboard, you don't have to go buy a whiteboard. I just shared with you what I had and what worked for me. But anything at all, any form of teaching, or you can just look into the mirror. Oh, why am I even just talking about just the mirror, right? Because these days, because of technology, you can just create a small video of your own. If you have some kind of a device, maybe your phone or your laptop or your tablets or iPads, whatever it may be, maybe you could capture a small video of your own teaching and just keep watching it, and you will be amazed to see how much listening to yourself over and over again helps you remember concepts better. Try this out and then let me know how it works for you. Right, so we are nearing the end of the video. We have summarized, we have talked about 3 top study hacks. We will be talking about more in the upcoming videos, hopefully, but these three are among my favorites. First of all, identifying your strengths and weaknesses, your strong and weak subjects, and your strong and weak times of the day. Secondly, having a clear plan for yourself, having a clear daily routine and a weekly routine. And the third one, teach. And that's about it from my side for the time being. Please comment below as you always do, and please hit the like button if you have enjoyed this video, and if you have anything more to share that you think others would benefit from, please do feel free to put it in the comment section below. I would love to read that as well. So until we meet again, stay happy, stay safe, and bye-bye.